Yo, what's going on, guys? This is SoulTracker, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to get a free server with Minecraft Hosting.pro, as well as just like a review and a showcase of the host in general. So, before we get right into it, I just want to mention, if you guys do have a server already with Minecraft Hosting.pro, or are planning to get one, you can use the code SOULCODES for 10% off any purchase. This means that you can use it for the first time, or if you're renewing, you can also use that discount code. And just keep in mind that it only matters for one server per account. So if you have multiple servers on one account, you can only use the code on one specific server. So here is the main things right here. Here are all the servers that you can get. You can get the free man, and on screen now is going to be like the little timestamps in the video that I will cover certain points. So if you're just concerned about getting a free server, you can go ahead and skip through the video, or if you just want to watch the whole video in general, that would be pretty awesome, and make sure you leave a like. So here we go. We got the 2GB servers. These are all the different servers, and the prices pretty well balanced, not gonna lie. So you got 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, and 10GB servers. I definitely recommend following them on Twitter, because as you see, they announced their different features that they add to the control panel, as well as there are some discount codes for like holidays and stuff. So make sure, definitely recommend follow them on Twitter. And then over here is specifically the most insane thing: 3 million servers launched. That is insane. That is so insane. That is crazy to me. 3 million. So on the right hand side of the screen, that's going to be the little number system. So that's going to be like after report throughout the video. And then over here are the different types of versions that you can have. So you can have the default Minecraft, Snapshots, Bucket, Spigot, and then Feed the Beast, which is a whole bunch of different types of mod packs, Tekkit, Forge, and Sponge. And then they also have the Bucket one-click installations, which is pretty awesome. They also have pretty decent hardware. They have the E3s and then SSDs, which is really good. They also have the mobile app, and which is pretty cool about the mobile app, that you can check, as you see here, the features that you can check it. You can have the console, and then you can send in tickets and just manage your server from that. I really wish that they can have like updating your FTP. I hope they add that feature pretty soon, because that would be super helpful. And then here is another insane feature that they just added. So overclock hardware basically gives you a 50% boost of your hardware, so your performance will be insanely smooth. They have Intel i7s, which is probably like one of the top ones. Not quite sure on that, but it's definitely very, very up there, and that is insane. And then they have the World Fiber Network, which is pretty good from Europe to North America. And then here are the other features that they have. They have their own custom control panel, DDoS protection, 24 access, and then file manager, backups, and then all that. And then here are the partners. So if you want to get like a discount with Bycraft, so if you click that, you can get the 30-day Bycraft, and this is actually what you need for the free server. And then also for engine, it's engine that you need one. So you also have the little discount codes for 30 days off that. So now we'll get into getting a server. All right, so now I'm gonna show you guys how to get the free server. If you guys actually want to buy a specific server, just click on the package that you want. But I'm gonna go with the free man in this video. So right here is where you can select the different versions. You can have the PC or Pocket Edition, and with the brand new update, now everything is like cross compatible, which is super sick. So you can select the Pocket Edition and run your Pocket Edition server from here as well, or you can just do the PC version. So for this video, I'm doing the PC version. And then right here, you can select your location, North America or Europe. And then now you can enter the IP address. So I'm going to do YT for vid. And then over here, you can select the subdomain. So you can have all these different ones if you want. I'm going to go with crafted.pro. And then right here is where you can select the specific version. So as you see, we have all the Feed the Beast, which is all the mod packs, which is pretty sweet. This one is even more mod packs. And if you want like a specific one, for example, CrazyCraft. CrazyCraft is pretty popular. So if you do CrazyCraft, you can just search it up and it will pop up if it's available. For this version, I'm going to be doing Spigot 1.12, which is a brand new one. And then down over here is the 10 days, and then over here are the features. There's only will be 4 slots because of the free server. And then over here, the options, it's not available for the free server, but I have this page over here. This, if you're actually buying a server, this is where you can add all the specific features. So you can have a live map viewer, and here is the premium hardware. So premium hardware gives you the i7-4790K, which is the 25%. And then if you want that, it also is $5 extra. Or if you want the overclocked hardware, which is the same one, you just click it and it's $10. And then if you want dedicated support, there are a list of features what dedicated support is. And then you have a custom domain, advanced backups, and whatever. So this is only if you're buying an actual server. And make sure you have to, as you see, you have to have the option selected before you buy the server. If you're renewing it, you cannot get the overclocked hardware or the premium hardware. So live map viewer and then the advanced backups are the ones that you can get after you buy them. The rest of these, you have to purchase them when you're buying your server for the first time. And make sure you just keep that in mind. So go ahead and close that. And then go ahead and click order. And basically what this says is that we offer 10 days on Tango servers for all Engine affiliates. So basically, this is where you need your Engine accounts. And then sign up if you don't have an Engine account already, and then you're pretty much set. So after you make your website, just enter the URL right here and just click yes, give it a try. And then as you see, I don't have a URL right now, but I'll go ahead and make one, and then we should be set. All right, so after you have made your Engine site and put it in the free server, this is what it will look like. You can ignore all the rest of these because those are my personal servers, but this is the one that we made for this Freeman tutorial. As you see, this is the control panel. They have their own custom control panel, which is super, super awesome. And here is where you can select the different versions. So you have your vanilla, craft bucket, snapshot, and the spigot. These are just like the default ones. If you want to change it to a mod pack, I will show you guys how to do that in a little bit. But we're going ahead and change it to the very latest version. And just save your settings down here. This is where you can renew the server if your payment runs out. And then as you see, these are not available, so you have to buy it, as I said, before you buy your server. I mean, you have to select it before you buy your server. And then over here, and here is where you can upgrade to all of the, like, Titania, Iron, Prime, Ultron, Laura, or Orion. And as you see, this is the 32, the 24, the 16, 8, and so on. So that is what I mentioned before. And then we'll go ahead and back to the server. And then this is where you can modify everything. Resource pack, the message of the day. You can just say, hi, bro. And then server name. The generated settings, the level name, this is like the world name, so you can change it to map or world or my custom world or whatever. Here is where you can select the Java version, which is super, super helpful because a lot of plugins nowadays are requiring it to be Java 8. So go ahead and click Java 8. Extra params if you want. I just leave it to none. And then the default game mode, survival, creative, adventure, or spectator. The difficulty, max players, you cannot change that for the free server. And then the build height, and then spawn protection, and view distance. And over here are the server properties. Allow PvP, enable whitelist, and all that great stuff. So you can have all that. And over here is the plugin. So here's the plugins. So if you go ahead and click plugins, since we're on the very latest version, I don't know if anyone will work, but to basically install it, you just click on it and then go ahead and click this arrow, and that will install it, which is pretty sweet. It does say it up to 1.12, so hopefully it will work, so we can check that out in game after we get all the features updated. So if you want to click the info will take you to the page itself, and you can see all commands and everything on the page itself, which is pretty cool. You also have the map settings. Basically, if you want to add your own custom map with a specific scene, you can add it there. This is where the FTP, this is where you can modify your password if you want. And then address and user, this is where you use FileZilla or WinCP to upgrade everything. This is the plugins and plugins folder. You can modify everything in the config as well. This is the players that have are on the server or op players. That you see whitelist, ban IP, and ban players. And then this is the type. Here is where you have your console. As you see, there's nothing there. And maintenance is where you can select different versions, like wipe your server and select a different version if you want. like a mod pack or a specific like snapshot or something. So that is where you change your server version if you want to. So now we have everything down and ready, go ahead and start the server up, and we're going to ahead and let it load, and then we'll go in console to see if World Edit actually works on the very latest version. Go ahead on console. As you see, it is successfully started, and we pretty much have no errors, which is pretty cool. If you do have an error, it will pop up in red, which is fantastic, and it looks like it loaded, which is pretty cool. So let's go ahead and game. Alrighty, we are getting ready to join the server. As you see, here is the IP that we have made. Go ahead and join it, and let's see what happens. So alright, we are on the game, and everything looks to be amazing. Oh yeah, I forgot about the new feature with the inventory. That's awesome, guys. I actually really like that. It's pretty sweet. That's pretty cool. And let's see if World Edit works. Oh yeah, I'm not off. Let me op myself real quick, guys. Let me do that. There we go. Boom. We are now up, boom, baby. All right, wand, let me go game mode one real quick, see if World Edit works on the very latest version. Go ahead and select the position right here. So set lava. We're gonna grief my own server. All right, there we go. Oh, that's crazy. All right, let's try TPS. TPS is 20, fantastic. So yeah, that is the video. Hope you guys did enjoy. Let me know if you have any questions for me down below in the comments, and we're just gonna finish griefing my server. I will see you guys next time. Peace out.